Marta, Marta, you are anxious and worry about many things, but one thing is necessary, and that is what your sister has selected and will not be taken away from. In the first reading today of the Gospel, we find a parable. In the first reading, we find Abraham as he was resting from the heat of the day. He saw three men going by him, and instead of being alienated and thinking about him, he said to himself, those men are really tired. So he called them and told them to come and bathe their feet. Remember, they were walking on the desert, so hot the sand, that they need to bathe their feet, to clean their feet from the sand between their toes. And while they were doing this, he said, and by the way, you are hungry. Let me prepare something for you to strengthen yourself, and then you can go on your way. And they agreed. And so Abraham went to Sarah and said, make some robes. To his servant he said, kill this deer and prepare it. And then he went and bring some milk himself and curd. And after everything was prepared, he put it in front of them. And while they were eating, they said to him, where is your wife Sarah? She said, in the tent. Remember, Sarah was not a spring chick. She was in her 80s. And she was sterile. She cannot have children. And these three said to him, when we come next year, your wife will be fondling a baby. Imagine what Abraham felt. He said, they all know. But then he believed, because God made a promise. He who was faithful to him and obeyed him is going to make him a father of a great generation. We go in the Gospel today and we find Jesus, when he is tired, he wants to go to his friends. There in Bethany, a little bit away from Jerusalem. And there was Martha, her sister Mary, and their brother Lazarus. They love to have Jesus coming to them. Of course, when he comes with the crew, 12 men with him. And so, when they see him coming, Martha was very concerned of preparing a good meal and also prepare a room for Jesus to rest. And while she was doing so, she looked, and her sister Mary was there on the floor listening to she said, can you believe this woman? He said, I am all bothered here with all the preparation for the meal and so on. And her, yeah, she is not even concerned. Lord, send her to help me. Jesus did not scold Martha. But listen what he said to her. Martha, Martha, you worry about many things. But one thing is necessary. And that is what your sister has chosen, and will not be taken away from her. And we know that today, in our daily busy lives we have time for everything, but unfortunately we don't have time for. If I ask you to make a little meditation today and said how much time I give the Lord in my course of the week, many of you will say, well, I go to Sunday Mass, it's not enough. There are people who do not even scratch the surface because we don't have an obligation, but we have a relationship. And that relationship is calling for intimacy. Imagine you have a friend or somebody in your family, or even somebody that you love, and you wait 1 week for your call or visit. That relationship is not going to flourish. But on the contrary, if you really are in love with this person or delight this person, and you call this person on a frequently and daily basis, well, that's going to flourish. Because the more you know each other, the more you grow together and grow in love with each other. And that is the same thing with God. God is not there to meet him and we bust him when we need him. Because my wife is going to surgery. Because my husband is going for interview. Because my son is ill. Because I need you to give me good results when I go to the doctor. God is not a God of use, but a God of relationship. And he wants us to have that relationship. And that's why today he said to Martha, Martha, you worry about many things. And believe me, I begin from myself. You worry about many things. How we are going to pay the bills, how we are going to make this, how we are going to make this, and how are we going to make ends meet, and all kinds of things that we have that sometimes are necessary things. But then Jesus said to her, but Mary has selected the best part and will not be taken away from it. Because many times we do things because it's our concern. And it's good that we are enterprises. But then we forget that we are creatures and we have a report with the creature. Without the creature, we are nothing. And that's why everything we do many times is like we are digging in the water. We don't go nowhere. And that's why it is very important that this relation with Jesus is not just Sunday mass, not some prayers that we say as we go behind the steer of the car, not some prayers that we say if we remember at night, or some blessing we say before dinner, but it's a continuation of a relationship. That we need this Lord to be with us and be side by side with us so that we can confer to him. And he will be part of our decisions and our speeches and our actions. This is what he is saying to Martha. He's saying, Martha, I understand that I put you through much trouble. And then, unfortunately, you know, it takes time and preparation. But also, we have to balance ourselves. Not everything is work, but we have to balance work with prayer. In fact, St. Paul said, everything we do is a prayer. Whether I eat, whether I sleep, whether I work, if you have this notion within you that everything you do is doing God's will, and you have been created in this time, in this space for a reason, everything you do is fulfilling God's will. Now I'd like to go into the second reading today and see what St. Paul has to say about this. St. Paul is writing to the people of Colossae, and he's saying to them, you know, God loves us very much. And in the fullness of time, he sent his son. And his son died and rose for us. So through him, we have reconciliation with the Father, and again, we become in friendship with him. And because of this, that sacrifice that he put on the cross, he left it in our hands. So that we who participate in the hardship of the gospel, as I am doing, I am continue to fill the lacking, what is lacking in the suffering of Christ. And so I am doing this for the church, for you. Because that mystery that was hidden from old is now revealed to us in the person of Jesus Christ, who is calling us to a relationship with him. And so, I have been called a minister of this gospel to teach. Some people want to preach to say jokes at the altar and don't tell the teaching of the church and don't tell people, you know, what they don't want to hear. What are we doing here? The early church were faithful to the teaching of the apostles. This is the ministry when the bishop lay hands on us. That we are faithful to the teaching of the church, not what I want or my ambition, but the gospel. And And that's why we need to believe in the gospel and preach the gospel. You cannot preach it before you believe it. And that's very important, St. Paul said, that's why I am a teacher. That's why sometimes I correct you. That's why sometimes I uphold you in your faith, because I am preparing you for the last time that we have on the face of the earth to meet our Savior. Each one of us have one mission, and that is the pilgrim journey that we have towards our destination. And one day, every one of us have to account himself to the Lord. And the Lord is going to ask us, I have voiced my message to you. I have given you much, and much is expecting of you. Now, how are we going to put these readings in our daily lives? Many people say, well, I am so busy, I don't know how the day go by. I need more hours in the day because I cannot accomplish everything I want to accomplish. Well, first of all, you have to understand that all of us has one head, 10 fingers, 2 feet, and 2 hands. We are not going to do work of 3 or 4 people. And that's why we need to have a balance in our life. And that balance comes through a schedule. That you are going to fulfill a schedule. Everyone knows that in the morning you wake up, after you wash, you put yourself in that car, and then you go to work. After work, you are going to come home and you are going to do other chores that is required. But you have to understand that there are 6 days, and so you have to balance. And sometimes, you know, you have to say, this evening, I am going to go to give 2 hours to read the scriptures, to study the scriptures. Maybe, you know, I need to really join somebody who knows the teaching of the church. Maybe the parish is going to put an evening for adult education. I attend. Because by confirmation, we don't have a license of doctrine in the faith. We don't even trace the service. We think we know it, but we don't. The more you grow, the more you talk, you think how much you don't know. We are always on the road to becoming. Because that is the way we are living. If we are dead, then there is no future, there is no if or but. There is no growth. But while we are living, because we are living bodies, we are always growing. Growing in age, as you can see in the mirror in the morning, or you grow in age. I see myself. All those, you know, all those looks that I had when I was 21 is gone. Now I am an old suit. But the thing is, we grow in age, but also we grow spiritually. And we mature spiritually. The other thing that the Lord is asking us today to meditate is, how is my heart open to those who comes in my life? Maybe somebody moved in your neighborhood. Do you make any attempt to welcome those people? Or you say, well, you know, they learn as I learned, the hard way. Christian ways. No. Do we make a stride that when we see somebody in the church who are strangers or who are new, we try to reach out to them? This is the idea of ushers. This is the idea of hospitality, that I ask the ministers to go and greet people. Because we need to welcome people as they come, to worship with us, to ease their tension, to welcome them to worship. This is the idea of, you know, looking for those people in our neighborhood who are elderly and who are people who does not have people who care about them, that you reach out to them. This is the kind of Christianity, this is the kind of parish that we really need to have. When I look at a parish, I don't look at these walls, I look beyond these walls of the parish. What our parishioners are doing to be hospitable, to be kind and reach out to others. Because that is the only way we can grow here. Remember that we ourselves has found those people in our lives. We find our parents. Many times when we did something that is not good in their eyes, they point fingers to us and really correct us. We find that teacher. I find two teachers in my life who really point to me that I can be better and I can have better grades, that I am getting a little lazy. Yes, it's true that God gave me a gift, that if I see something, if I hear something, I can repeat it word by word to you. And not only repeat it, I know what they were talking about. But sometimes you don't study because of this. Because of this, then, when you go to the exam and they throw you something that you have heard it maybe 3 or 4 months ago, it's not clear in your mind because you did not review it. And one time a teacher called me and she said to me, I need to see you after school. She said, you know that you are an A plus? Why are you B? I said, because that's the grade you people give me. No, she said, because you are not doing your best. You're not studying. So then I promised that one term, every Thursday, I will stay with her so that I will benefit from her tutoring or whatever she was doing to me to grow. And believe me, I have A plus in my answer. There was a priest, the pastor, I told him how many times he locked me in the room upstairs. God bless his soul. He would give me a letter, and then he would correct it. Of course, there was a lot of interruption. His mother wanted to go shopping for her or do errands for her, and he said to her, do not even call his name, because that is the time that you need to study. These are the people that you never forget. These are the people that are benefactors in your life. And if you have received it, why not give it to others? You see somebody who unfortunately they don't have the means, or something happened to them, why not reach out to them and do something for them? And believe me, when you see somebody, you have something in your heart telling you that this boy, this girl needs some push, some help. Do it. That is Christianity. This is what Jesus is telling us in the Gospel to Mary and to Martha. And this is what Abraham did. Imagine Abraham, he was entertaining angels. Those who interrupt the scripture say, interpreted the scripture said, that those men were three angels. Imagine if he said, it's not my business after all, let them go. They will not give him the renewal of the promise. But his wife, Sarah, will have a baby. And she did. A year later, she did. At the age of 99, imagine. But this is what we is all about. As I told you in the beginning of the Mass, this weekend, we are celebrating the feast of Our Lady. Now many of you know that Our Lady was the most blessed one, that God loved her so very much. And that's why God gave her that privilege. That as St. George said to us, the Blessed Mother gave us three very special gifts. One of them is the brown scapular. Second is the rosary. And the third is the Immaculate Conception Medal. And those three are three signs by which she really is helping us to achieve our goal to heaven. The first above all is the scapular. In 1251 she gave it to St. Simon Stamp, the general of the order. And she said, by this you will save your people. By this you will be my child. What does this scapular mean? That's why we wear it in the back and the front. Is that we take on our shoulders the cross of Jesus. That is the symbol of the Court of Arms of Carmel. Is the mountain, Mount Carmel, and then the three stars, the three virginity of Mary, before, during, and after. But then there is a cross, because Mary unites us with Calvary. Because at Calvary, she becomes our mother. So you see, the relationship we have with Blessed Mother is a relationship of every day of our lives. That we too, we need to really immerse ourselves to do God's will like you did. We need to immerse ourselves, as St. Paul said, that we continue to show and help each other by helping each other carrying the cross and bearing the marks of Christ. As he said, I continue in my body with his lugging in the passion of Christ. But then there is one thing that he is saying to us, that we need to be of service to each other, that we need to reach out to each other. What good is it that I say, I belong to the congregation of Carmel, if I am not a servant to others, if I don't imitate Christ, my master, who will become my servant? My dear people, as we go to celebration of the Mass today, let us pray that we open our hearts to be more generous our time, to give God his due, and to really understand that the relationship we are going to build with him is going to be effective in the life of him. Your relationship with others identify how much you are in God. You tell me how much you really care for people, and I tell you how much you love your God. And I conclude with the words of John. If you cannot see God in the brother that you see and touch, how are you going to tell me that you believe in God, that your eye and your ear cannot hear? God bless you.